Morning everyone. I'm coming on to share with you what I have made for the present collaboration, PT Tag collaboration hosted by Ashley of Paper and Twine. Here we are. This is the hashtag to use, hashtag PT Tag Club. And every month, Ashley pulls out one or two prompts depending on how many days there are in the month. So this is August, so there are 31 days in August. So she's pulled out two prompts, and the prompts are intents and cogs. So the idea is to make a tag or two tags with those prompts. So either can make just choose one of the prompts, or we can choose both of them and make one tag, or we can choose both of them and make two tags. There is no pressure, you know, it's just a, you know, join in if you want type collaboration. And anyway, I thought I would have a go. So I've pulled together a few things. I've got this stencil. This is a funky fossil design. I'm not sure how I got this. It must have been in a giveaway, or somebody gifted it to me, because I certainly didn't buy this one, but I don't recall where I got it from. I've pulled out this as well. This is a sheet from Dawn of Shiny Silver Treasures, a colouring in sheet that she produced. Well, she gave it as a freebie in some of the orders, and it goes very well with her Vintage Treasures collection, of which I've got a couple of pieces, some scraps from one of the papers, which have, these have got cogs on, so I thought I might be able to use these. And I've got my tag. So I have cut out three of the cogs and coloured them in. I tried to make the colour quite intense, so deep. That was my thoughts. And the first thing I'm going to do is put some colour using the stencil. I'm just going to use a sponge dauber, and I've got this one in brown. Let's see if there's any ink left on it, because sometimes there's enough ink just to give some effect. Yeah, there's enough here. So that sort of, I hope there's enough. So this will be quite light in the background. Okay, you can see that. So that's that. And then I thought maybe putting my cogs, something like this, on the tag. I can hardly see the background. I thought of doing something like this, or putting this here, and maybe putting this like that. I don't know. Maybe like this, just so we can see a bit of the background. Or maybe bunched up together. Actually, I think I like that the best, so that's what we're going to go for. So I'm just going to stick it down using my glitter glue. Okay, so I have chosen to go for both prompts in one tag. I do tend to do that if I can, or just do one of the prompts which takes my fancy. I'm not very imaginative when it comes to, you know, thinking outside the box or anything like that. So my glue's dried up. I don't think I had this. Just take this nozzle off if I can. I'll clean that up later, and I'll just use it without the fine tip. do tend to find that it rushes out if I don't use that fine tip, but it does get clogged from time to time. So, right, so I'm going to stick this, where was it, about here, sort of centered as best as I can. Okay, that's that. And then I think this was, I can't remember how these were now. Something like that. Yeah. So this paper is very thin, so I'm not going to bother to put something underneath these where they hang over the edge. They're not going to sort of cause a dip or anything. So this is just a quick and simple tag. It doesn't have to be anything, you know, sort of wildly huge or anything like that. But I am going to put some colour around the edge. So I'm going to get the vintage photo. Oops. And this will be more intense colour. With the dauber. Cogs you tend to think of steampunk or vintage, don't you, with cogs, and you tend to think, well, at least I do, tend to think of rusty cogs. I mean, I'm sure cogs are still used today, but they usually, when you find them, you know, sort of, I remember finding lots when I was clearing out my parents' shed, and that, so yeah, so there we are. So I think that looks better. There we are. So thank you for watching. Do go over to Ashley's channel, it's Paper and Twine, and give her some YouTube love if you don't already subscribe to her. She does have a second channel called One Stitch After Another, which is more sewing and knitting related, but equally wonderful channel. So if that takes your fancy, that's you know, you could go to that channel as well. So thank you for watching. Take care, everybody. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you all again soon. Bye for now.